Good morning, students. Today we are going to study about the spherical mirrors. What are spherical mirrors? Now, name itself suggests the mirror which is in spherical shape. Okay, it is called as spherical mirrors. In plane mirror, what you have studied, the mirror is totally plain. Okay, it has a surface which is totally plain. But in spherical mirror, what happens? It shape may be ellipsoidal, any shape it can contain. Okay, but how it is? It is in a spherical manner. That is called as spherical mirrors. There are two types of spherical mirrors. That is concave mirror and convex mirror. How the mirror is formed? That I am going to explain. And today you are going to study the terms related to the spherical mirrors, and these terms are very important for your further studies. So you have to listen it carefully and also write in your notebook. Now here you can see the spherical mirrors are of two types, that is concave mirror and convex mirror. Now here I will draw a spherical mirror, that is like this sphere shape. Okay, now what happens, how these two the types of a mirror, if you will cut this sphere, now it is a spherical mirror in sphere shape. If I will cut this, okay, if the spherical mirror is cut into two parts, okay, so if one part is reflecting, if one part is coated, if this outer part is coated, and what happened, then inner part acts as a reflecting surface. Okay, if the inner part acts as a reflecting surface, then this mirror is called as concave mirror. This mirror is called as concave mirror. And if the inner part is coated, if you will coat this inner part, and if the outer part acts as a reflecting surface, if you will see this part act as a reflecting surface, then it is called as convex mirror. Okay, and here inner part is the reflecting surface. So many students have doubt, many students are confused related to these two mirrors, which one is concave and which one is convex. Okay, so for removing your confusion, I will tell you one idea how to keep this in mind. If you will see this concave mirror, this has a cave shape. If you will see, this has a cave shape, and in this concave in this cave shape, the inner surface, the cave surface inside part, acts as a reflecting surface. Okay, light rays falls inside the cave. Here you can keep in mind, here light rays falls on the inside cave part and it reflects back. So the inside reflecting part is called as, means the mirror which is having inside the reflecting part inside, it is called as concave mirror. This way you can keep in mind the convex, concave lens and convex lens. This is an easy way you can keep in mind. Now here in convex mirror, you as I have explained you, that outer part acts as a reflecting surface. Okay, so these are the two types of concave and convex mirror. As in mathematics, in circle you have studied some concept, you have studied the center, you have studied radius, you have studied diameter. Okay, in the circle, same terms you are going to apply for this spherical mirror, and from that terms which you are going to apply, that you are going to study in physics also, but in little bit different manner you are going to study. Okay, as you, I hope you all have understood this concave mirror and convex mirror. So now I will explain you one by one the terms related to the surface spherical mirrors. Okay, now for that purpose I will draw a sphere again here. You can consider it as a circle also to relate the terms. Okay, now first term you are going to study center of curvature. Now as you know, in circle you have studied the center. Where is the center in the circle? The midpoint of the circle is called the center of the circle. Similarly, for this spherical mirror, what is the center of the curvature? As I have cut this into two parts, so two reflecting surface. Okay, so the middle part, here also same concept, center of curvature, that is it is denoted by C. So what is the center of curvature? In the circle we are using it as a origin. Okay, but here you are using it as a center of curvature C, means it is the center of the spherical mirror. Okay, it is denoted by the letter C. Here again, if you are getting confusing, I will show it in a mirror. Okay. Here now this is a half cut mirror with the concave mirror. For your understanding, I have taken a half part so that you will easily understand. So this is a sphere and I have cut this. See, this is the center. See, center of curvature. Same for the half, for convex mirror, for concave mirror, this is the center of curvature. Okay, now second term is radius of curvature, that is, it is denoted by letter R. Now, as in the circle, you have studied radius, similarly, this you have studied in the circle, radius, okay, R. Here two radius are there, here, okay, both it together combined for diameter. So this part I have considered here, okay. So what will be the radius of the curvature? If you will take from here, this till here, I have drawn a dotted line. This is your R, radius of curvature. It is the radius of sphere of mirror. Okay, understood? Radius of curvature. Now third, you are going to study about the pole. What is pole? Now, as we have considered here, I have drawn a radius over here. You can see this is the half part of the sphere. And this is the midpoint of this half part. If you will consider this half mirror, this is the midpoint. So, the midpoint of the mirror is called as pole. Here you can see geometric center of spherical reflecting surface is called a pole. Whenever you are drawing a concave mirror or convex mirror, if you will take a midpoint here of any surface, this or this, so this is will be your pole P. Here also, if you will see, this will be your pole, means it is the midpoint, geometrical point or geometrical center of the mirror, it is called the pole. Okay, so here where will be the pole, this will be your pole P. Now fourth is the principal axis. What is the principal axis? Now we are going to draw a line here, a straight line which passes through the center, means which passes through the pole and the center of curvature. It is a straight line or it is an axis which passes through the pole and the center of curvature. It is called as principal axis. See, straight line joining curvature to pole. It is called as principal axis. So here now this is over. Now for understanding curvature, radius, pole, I have drawn this. Now here you can understand this. Now focus F. What is focus F? This part is very important. Now see, as I have drawn the concave mirror, so what happened? This is the basic concept I have drawn. So what is the focus? Focus means when the light falls on the mirror and it reflects back, at that time it come and focus at one point. Okay, it come and meet at one point, and that point is called as focus. If you will see here, suppose now I am drawing, as this is a reflecting surface, I am drawing few light rays which are coming towards the reflecting surface. Now it is falling on this reflecting surface and it is reflecting back. Now as it is falling here, it is reflecting back. Now it is this rays are reflecting back, okay, after falling. And you can see after reflecting back, it meets at one point. You can see it has fallen on the surface and it has reflected back. After reflecting, it meets, all the rays meet at one point, and that point is called as focus. Okay, and how is the focus? From this you can identify. See, this is the radius of curvature, this is the pole, and in between it is the focus, means it is properly located in between pole and center of curvature. One more condition is that now, as I have drawn this for concave mirror, for convex mirror it is opposite. Okay, for convex mirror it is opposite. Now in convex mirror, if you will take this surface, inner part is coated, outer part, this is the principal axis, this is the pole. Okay, now as here, so it is little bit opposite because this part is the reflecting surface, outer part is the reflecting surface. So here you can see the center of curvature will be here, this part. Okay, so here what happens? See, light rays falls on the surface and now it reflects back. All this you are going to study in the next video. Just for understanding the focus, I am showing this. Now when you will extend this, so now when you will extend this, this will act as a focus. What you have done, you here in this condition, it has focus. Behind this, you are going to study in next video clearly. For your understanding, I have just drawn this. Now here you can see, when narrow beam of rays, this parallel beam of rays, it is parallel to the parallel axis. These rays are parallel to the principal axis. Okay, if the rays are parallel to the principal axis, it is called as paraxial rays. Okay, it is called as paraxial rays. These paraxial rays, when it is incident on the surface, what happens? It reflects back. Okay, and the how the reflects back, it if it converges together. Now you have studied the concept of converging and diverging. Converging means coming to a point and diverging means going away. Now here you can see it converges at one point. Okay, if the rays converges at one point, where it converges? In the concave mirror. Okay, the reflected rays converges in concave mirror, it diverges in convex mirror. Okay, if you will see, it gets diverges, it goes outward, it doesn't meet at one. What we are doing, we are just focusing at one point. So when it diverges, where it diverges in the convex mirror. Okay, from the point of principal axis, and this is called as focus. F, it is denoted by F. And what is the focal length? Focal length, it is the distance between pole and the principal axis, sorry, principal focus. If you will see this much distance from pole and focus, this much distance, it is called as focal. What will be, or it is half to the radius of curvature. If you will see the radius from center to the pole, this is the radius and focus is half to it. So what will be the formula of the focal length? Focal length F equal to R divided by 2, that is radius of curvature divided by 2. This formula is very important to find the focal length of the mirrors. Okay, so I hope you all have understood this concept. Still, if you have a doubt, you can ask me. Okay, thank you.